Hi, this is Nat from the Sport Rec and Health team at Leisure Networks. Welcome and thank you for joining our virtual forum to support the active participation and social connection of people with disabilities in local community. We'd really like to introduce Tyler and Sam. If you're looking to get more actively connected and involved in your local community, here are some great tips from Sam and Tyler.
I encourage as well for people like Sam and myself to put themselves out there and just reach out to any club and you know, and if they needed support, they can get that and help them overcome those barriers with confidence or being able to participate.
Hear more from Tyler and Sam as they're joined with Luke from the Leisure Network Sport Rec and Health team, Scotty from the Newcomb Football Netball Club, and Trav Zimmer from Sport4All at Geelong City Council as they discuss ways to improve and remove the impact of barriers that limit involvement and participation of young people with disabilities in sport and active recreation settings.
Once that's happened, it's actually gone national through some of the networks of the families. They put stories out that their kids were starting to play mainstream sport and went into state, and the barriers have started coming down, and hopefully they can come down more and more clubs get involved, and more younger kids are actually out playing the great game of footy.
For people with disability who are unusual where to start, what's the best way to get connected?
Obviously, my connection with Luke at Leisure Networks, I would say that'd be the first port of call. And then from there, with Luke's knowledge of the sports in the region, he would be able to branch out to different clubs who are involved and go that way. Obviously, see a great Geelong also.
Yeah, definitely. So with my role at Citibank Geelong with the Sport4All program as an inclusion coach, it's really important not only to participate on field, it's really important that people with disability have a social connection. They can be impacted by being involved.
You more about how a community services club were able to have a positive impact on barriers that limit involvement and participation of people with disabilities. The strategies talked about here may inspire you to respond to barriers impacting young people locally to support inclusion and diversity in your sporting community. This is where you also meet me as I join the conversation with both Tyler and Sam.
Some of the players we've had play are brothers and sisters, and they've been able to play at our club now. We've had a whole family come through and play. So the two brothers now play and the sister. My first experience with working with people with disabilities was with cricket. We run the league around Geelong, and to have a home game and one of our players come in and tell her grandma that this is my club. And that's what it's about. It's about community and being part of that broader picture.
That's where we would be. More people are part of that. They come there instead of being anxious because they have a disability.
Yeah. And some of our members who have been involved with our AusKeeper are autistic, so we're actually, with the help of the footy club here, we're actually going to set up like a small sensory area so they can come on match days and still be part of the club, go and kick the footy with brother. But if they want a timeout, they've actually got an area where they can go and have a timeout.
Oh, that's fantastic.
So through a football club, we run the canteen. So through working at the club and volunteering, you could actually pick up skills that could help with employment. So there's some of the agencies now go out and I see offer in cafes and that.
Yeah.
So through the footy club, you can start just learning how to cook a barbecue and then work your way through different jobs on the fryer and get some training through the clubs.
Okay.
So it's also teaching you some life experience as well. Some I'm not very good on computers. Operating scoreboards. How do you do all the advertising on scoreboards? Things like that. Newsletters. There's all different roles around clubs that everyone can get involved in and help out.
One aspect that we like to at the Sport4All program is not only about participation on the field, but participation off the field. And one of the things, the key areas that we've been looking at is people with disability could become disability inclusion officers, so that can be a point of contact. So when someone else comes into the club who has a disability, they've got someone to relate to, and they can help them with all sorts of different accessible areas. So if there's a stairs that they, you know, that they might need ramps or, you know, just things like that. So that's some area that we're trying to implement with clubs at the moment as well. So that's something to look out towards too.
Question where you just said offices before, like having a ramp for the disability, like saying wheelchairs, access, you know what I'm talking about,
yeah.
Your football club. But I was saying, what's the best advice for the, in the future for the Newcomb Football Club, like for the disability thing? How do you feel doing that for the conversation? You know what I mean?
Yep. So it's providing more opportunities.
Yeah.
Well, we hope that obviously with our all abilities footy we're doing in term two, term three, we want to start getting into all abilities netball.
Okay.
Because there is a big gap through our program and the rule changes we've had. We can have from age 5 to 12. We can provide football opportunities through mainstream sport. Once you get to 12, the next step is feeder football. That's 18, 16 up. So there's still a gap in Geelong we need to fill, and hopefully in the next 2 or 3 years we'll be able to fill that gap and eventually have a pathway for people with disabilities to play sport. Mm-hmm. So at the moment we have a pathway for male, female, now we want to produce a pathway as well. So you come along to a session in the Auskick. Once you finish with the Auskick, you'll be able to move up to junior football if you want to play mainstream. Otherwise there'll be another program for people with disability, and then from that move up to feeder football.
To have, and it's really important to keep the conversation going about particularly around creating opportunities for people with disabilities. And there certainly are those opportunities within the Barwon region, and it extends to all other local government areas as well too. But certainly just to hear your experiences and shared experiences is really, really quite valuable. So really, really thank you for your time.
Thanks to the customers at Encompass, Leisure Networks, Sam, Tyler, Scotty, Trav, the GMHBA Stadium Trust, and our friendly camera lady, Chrissy G.